إن الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. وبعد, we have been speaking about the importance of creating our own balance sheets and putting in those balance sheets our assets and our liabilities that we will face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with. And as I mentioned, alhamdulillah, we must try to add to our assets as much as possible. Our assets are the good deeds that we do in this life, which all are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالْبَاقِيَاتُ الصَّالِحَاتِ. But with regard to the liabilities, there is, as I said yesterday, there are two kinds of liabilities. One is, which is a liability by itself. You do something wrong, you miss salah, it's a liability. But there are other kinds of liabilities which are not only liabilities by themselves, but they also cancel out the assets. And that is a much more dangerous kind of liability. And we talked about the first and most important of them yesterday, which is the issue of shirk. If you commit shirk, not only is it a liability by itself, but it also wipes out everything else. So all the good that you did also will get wiped out. So that's one. Today we will talk about another one. And may Allah forgive us. It's one of the very common ones that is there in our society. And that is the issue of ghibah, the issue of backbiting, the issue of slander. We all know the famous hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where one day he asked the Sahaba, Ridwanullahi alayhim ajmain, he said, according to you, who is a destitute person? Who is a poor person who has nothing? And they said, Ya Rasulullah, it is somebody who has no money. So Rasulullah said, no, the person who has no money is not poor. He said, the destitute person, and there's a difference between being poor and being destitute. Poor, you can be poor, but you can still have some resource. But a destitute person is someone who has absolutely nothing. And Nabi said that the destitute person is not the one who does not have dirham or dinar. He said, the destitute person is the one who will come before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment with good deeds the size of the mountain of Uhud. And those of us who have seen the mountain of Uhud, you know how huge, how big it is. So Rasulullah said, these are people who will come before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with good deeds the size of the mountain of Uhud. So Allah knows best what good deeds they will have, Hajj and Umrah and Khairat and Sadaqat and Tahajjud and fasting, and Allah knows best, whatever. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, these people will come before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with good deeds the size of the mountain of Uhud, but there will be a line of people who will be claimants against them. And these people will be people who, these ones who came before Allah with the good deeds, they wronged these other people. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say the other people will be Muslim, maybe non-Muslim. So it's a long line of people who these people have wronged. And he said, somebody they would have killed, somebody there whose property they would have unjustifiably and illegally occupied and taken, some people who they would have hit, some people who they would have backbited, who they would have spoken ill of behind their back, some people who they would have slandered, and so on and so on. All forms of oppression of other people, be it small, be it large. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do justice, and in exchange for what these people suffered in this world because of this individual, that individual's good deeds will be given to these people in accordance with what they suffered. So some will get more, some will get less, until a time will come when this whole mountain size of good deeds will be wiped out clean. But the line of claimants will still be there. Hadith. The line of claimants will be there. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will then say, well, this man has nothing now. He has no good deeds left. So what do you want me to do? And of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the answer to the question. The people will say, Ya Rabbal Alameen, he has no good deeds left. So give our evil deeds to him, and this will be done. And the person who came before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a mountain size of good deeds will go into the hellfire because of the evil deeds of somebody else, which he has acquired thanks to the oppression that he did. So now, we understand from this hadith that there are liabilities, there are deeds which are not only bad in themselves, but they also cancel out the good. The basic principle in deen is Inna al-hasanat yudhibna sayyat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, verily the good deeds wipe out the bad deeds. So that is the basic principle. The good deeds wipe out the bad deeds. So if you did something bad, then the thing to do is make tawbah and then give some sadaqah or make 2 rakat salah or fast or something to cancel out the bad deeds. So basic principle is the good deed cancels out the bad deeds. But there are certain bad deeds which cancel out the good deeds. And as I said yesterday, shirk is the number one in that. And the next one is slander. And may Allah forgive us. Slander is the backbone of our social life today. Illa mashallah, slander is the backbone of our social life. If two people meet, what do? They do this. Backbiting or slander. They talk about other people. Now, let us understand, what is ghibah? What is backbiting? Because people came, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill the qubur of the Sahaba Rizwanullahi alayhim ajmain with nur. Because of the questions they asked Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we got our deen. They came and asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this, and he talked about ghibah, they came and asked. And they said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but what I am saying about this person is true. What I am saying about this person is true. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when it is true, it is ghibah. If you are saying something which is not true, it is buhtan, which is slander, which is worse. There was a sahabi who committed zina. And it's a long story, I will not go into the details. But he came and he insisted, Ya Rasulullah, pronounce the punishment, Ya Rasulullah, pronounce the punishment. And after with great reluctance and after all sorts of insistence, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam pronounced the punishment. This person was taken and he was stoned to death. Soon after that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam overheard two other sahaba talking to each other between themselves. And one said to the other, he said, you know, that man, he did something wrong, Allah had covered it. He unnecessarily came and told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and then he got himself killed. What a fool he is. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was walking. He saw a dead donkey on a garbage heap. So he called these two and he said, go and eat that. He said, go and eat that. The dead donkey on the garbage heap. Now obviously they were very upset and, you know, they said, Ya Rasulullah, how can we eat a dead donkey? He said, what you did just now is worse than eating that dead donkey. What you spoke about that brother of yours, he said, that is worse than eating that dead donkey. This is ghibah. Because if you look at what they said, logically speaking, what they said was correct. The man need not have come and confessed. He could have made tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That was enough. But whatever it is, each person has a different level of taqwa. Wallahu a'lam, sahaba of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the point is that if it is true, it is ghibah. If it is not true, then it is slander, which is even worse. Somebody came to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they said, Ya Rasulullah, they spoke about two ladies. One was his wife, the other one somebody else. And they said, they are suffering from terrible stomach pain. And you know, this has been going on for a few days. And we are giving all sorts of medicines. Nothing is happening. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, call them. They came. He said, bring a bowl. They brought a bowl. He said, vomit. And the two women vomited. And they vomited out lumps of flesh. So they were very surprised. They said, I never even ate this. I mean, this is raw meat. What? Rasulullah said, this is ghibah. You were doing ghibat of others. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Hujurat, it is very important for us to read those ayat of Surah Al-Hujurat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Hujurat that to do ghibat of your brother or sister is like eating the meat of your dead brother. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when you hear these words, you feel karahiyat, you feel very, you know, what kind of thing is this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is worse than that. To do this ghibat is like eating the flesh of your dead brother. That's why Imam Bukhari rahmatullah alayh, Imam Bukhari said, if I have to do ghibat, I will do ghibat of my mother, because at least my good deeds will go to my mother. I don't want my... Imagine, you see, the tragedy of this thing is such a senseless thing. We don't do ghibat of somebody we love, obviously. We do not do ghibat by itself means that you dislike the person. And that is the person you are giving your good deeds to. Well, what sense does it make? You know, if you really dislike the person, then at least don't give your good deeds to that person. Somebody came to Imam Shafi'i rahmatullah and they said, so and so is saying some bad thing about you. So Imam Shafi'i rahmatullah, he went to the market, he brought some fruits and he took to the man and he gave him a gift. So the man says, what is this? He said, you are giving me your good deeds, so I thought at least I must reciprocate and give you something in this dunya, because there I will get your good. So he said, in the akhirah, you are doing, you know, this favor to me by speaking ill about me, so at least in this dunya, let me give you some fruits, you know, have some fruits. It is such an evil. Again, also think about this. Two things I want to say. One is this hadith which I mentioned before you. When I first remember many years ago, when I read this hadith, I used to think to myself that, you know, how is it possible somebody comes with good deeds the size of the mountain of Uhud? Now one can understand that, you know, there are people to claim and so on, but how can that whole mountain finish? You know, who is so evil that he has done so much harm, I mean, so much thing to so many people, how is it possible the whole mountain will fit? Until many years later, I was thinking, I saw an email that somebody sent about another person. Right? This whole email is written about so-and-so, and in that email that so-and-so is given some bad names, and you know, he's slandered, and all sorts of aspersions are cast on him and so on. Now I thought to myself, Wallahi subhanAllah, today I understood the meaning of this hadith. How it is possible for the whole mountain of Uhud to be finished, because things like emails, things like letters, things like books in which we write the evil of somebody, which somebody did. You know, people have this great thing, they will write about the Nizam of Hyderabad and they will say, well, you know, he had a harem, and in the harem he had so many wives and he did this and he did that. I mean, what did the man do to you? He never did. Whatever he had, it was not your sister who was in his harem or something. Why are you bothered? You know. So the point is, people write all this. Now, I thought to myself, now I understood the meaning of this hadith. How it is possible for all this evil? Because that one email that you write, that one pamphlet which you write, that one letter you write, has eternal life. That will float around in cyberspace and it will go from person to person to person to person, thousands and thousands and thousands of people across the world spreading this evil which you started. So you wrote one letter, but that one letter will generate enough evil for you, or you wrote that one pamphlet, or you wrote that one book, or whatever you wrote. And you slandered somebody and you called somebody a bad name. And Surah Al-Hujurat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned these things specifically. How bad is it that you give a bad name to your brother after he has accepted Islam? He is your Muslim brother and you give him a bad name. Not because you love the man. No, because you want to slander him. You want people to make fun of him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, tell the men, do not make fun of other people. They may be better than you. Tell the women, do not make fun of other women. They may be better than them. Do not give each other bad names. Do not slander each other. It is like eating the flesh of your dead brother. Detail Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned. So now in this pamphlet or in this letter or in this book or whatever it was, on the email, you have slandered your brother and you have given a bad name to the person and so on, and this thing has eternal life and this thing floats around in cyberspace long after you are gone. Maybe you even died, maybe it is now, Allah knows best, you know, 20, 30, 40 years after you have died, and this is generating evil for you long after you are dead. Instead of some Isa alayhi sawab going, Isa alayhi azab is happening, and your khabar is filling up with fire instead of filling up with noor. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. How stupid is that? How completely stupid is that? And that is why the second thing which I, this is when I understood this, I said, yes, it is possible. It is indeed possible for there to be this long line which will exhaust all the good deeds. And wallahi, Allah knows, I talk about myself, I don't think I'm going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with any mountain of wahad worth of good deeds, you know. हमारे को कितना ढेरा मिला तो बड़ी बात है अब वो भी गारत करके गए तो क्या व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन इमेजिन एंड द अदर बिग इशू आई वाज थिंकिंग टू माय सेल्फ अगेन दिस रिफ्लेक्टिंग ऑन द सेम आया व्हाई इज अल्लाह सुभानहु व तआला मेकिंग सच अ बिग डील अबाउट दिस गिबा इतना लंबा चौड़ा क्या जरूरत है उसका सूरत हुजरात के अंदर पूरा डिटेल में एक एक व्हाट इज द नीड फॉर व्हाई इज देयर सो मच प्रॉब्लम विद दिस बोलते होगा नहीं अल्लाह सुब्हानहु व तआला मेड अ वेरी बिग डील अबाउट दिस एंड द रीजन इज दैट गीबत डिस्ट्रॉयज ब्रदरहुड गीबत डिस्ट्रॉयज द उम्मा द फाउंडेशन ऑफ दिस उम्मा इज द लव फॉर वन अनदर द ब्रदरहुड फॉर वन अनदर समबडी केम आई रिमेंबर दिस हियरिंग द स्टोरी एंड आफ्टर दैट आई हैव फॉलोड इट माय ओन लाइफ I think there's a story about either Marana Ilyas Rahmatullah Ali or about Marana Sayyid Ahmad Khan Sahab Rahmatullah Ali. Somebody came to him and they said, Hazrat, I want to tell you about so-and-so. And he immediately stopped him. He said, please, I don't want to know. He said, I do not want to know. Don't tell me. He said, no, I do not want to know. Because I don't want you to tell me something negative about this brother. Which will put that thought in my mind about that person. I have some good impression about him. Maybe the impression is wrong, doesn't matter. Even if it is wrong, I would like to stay with that wrong, good impression rather than get this so-called truth from you. He said, if you are so interested in him, go tell him. Go tell him, don't tell me. So similarly, the other day somebody sent me an email, a good brother of mine, may Allah bless him. And good human being because he didn't tell me something. He said, somebody was speaking ill about you. Do you know what he was saying? Do you want to know what he was saying? So I said, Jazakallah khair. First of all, I must thank you for the wisdom to write an email like this that somebody was saying, he didn't say what it was. He said, somebody, he didn't even say who it was. Somebody was speaking ill about you. Do you want to know? So I said, no, Jazakallah khair. I do not want to know. I am not interested in knowing. Because first of all, that person is not my paymaster. He does not give me a salary. I am not asking him for a vote. I am already married. I am not interested in getting married again. So I am not interested in asking for his daughter for my to get married. I said, why the hell do I care? I don't care two hoots. Let him say what he wants. How does it make a difference to me? Makes absolutely no difference to me whatsoever. And I don't want to know. I don't want to burden my mind with some nonsense with somebody is talking. If he has genuine interest in me, and if he has the guts, then he should tell me. Why is he talking some evil about me behind my back? And if that person considers himself to be knowledgeable about Islam, then tell him to go read Surah Al-Hujurat. It's a shameful, shameful, shameful thing. That we consider ourselves to be Huffaz of Quran, Ulama of Deen. We do ghibat, we do namima. We cast aspersions on people, we slander people, and then we have no shame whatsoever to stand on the musalla and read Surah Al-Hujurat in Salah. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi rajiun. I mean, isse badhke behai kya hai? What is, you know, shamelessness beyond this? What is it? Tell me. You are reading that surah where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has condemned this and you have just committed all of that and more. And then you stand in Salah and you are leading Salah and you are reading the La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi rajiun. So ghibat is so bad because it destroys the foundation of the brotherhood of faith. It destroys the Muslim ummah. And that is what is happening today. That is what is happening today. May Allah forgive us. This is our social life. Our social life is only this. Talking about this one and that one and that one. Finally, to close, why do people do this? People do this because major reason is because of jealousy, hasad, and jealousy is like holding a live coal in your hand. It only burns you. The person that you are jealous about is sleeping peacefully in his bed. Nothing happens to him. The coal you are holding only destroys you, only burns you. It is just hasad. You don't like to see someone doing well. So you have to say something against that person. It doesn't harm that person anyway. It only harms you. And you are giving away your good deeds to that person. Alhamdulillah, That's why I say, may God bless the slanderers, because they give unasked. They give without asking. So, God bless the slanderer. Alhamdulillah, if you have got a few slanderers who are slandering us, Alhamdulillah, because while you are sleeping peacefully in your bed, a lot of good deeds are coming into your account. Alhamdulillah, why should we complain? We should not complain. Let there be more such. Makes no difference. La nafi wa la darra illallah. Nobody can cause any harm and nobody can cause any benefit except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This jealousy, this hatred of one another, this is the destroyer of this ummah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from this. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us. If among us there is anybody who has been doing this, Alhamdulillah, the door of tawbah is open. And if we make tawbah, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive us. And even whatever good deeds have gone to the other person, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to return them to us. Because we went by mistake, we make tawbah, inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from this terrible, terrible evil. And please remember that doing ghibat and sitting and listening to ghibat are equal. So it's not enough to say, mai to kuch nahi bola. Aap nahi bole, magar aap sun rahe the. Both are equally bad. Whether you are the one doing it or whether you were sitting there while somebody else was doing it, both are equally bad. We are supposed to stop the person who starts this kind of conversation immediately and say, sorry, I'm not interested in this. This is haram. Or if you cannot do that, then leave the place and go away and do not participate in that meeting. This is the requirement. If we don't do that, if we sit there and we are listening, then we are equally to blame. And not only is that person giving his good deeds, but you are also giving your good deeds to somebody who you may not even know, you don't even care. But because of the other person, now your good deeds are also going to that person who was being slandered or who was being backbitten. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us from this terrible evil and to give us the tawfiq to make tawbah and to arrange our lives in such a way that inshallah our liabilities do not cancel out our assets, and that we go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only with a balance sheet which has only assets, and all the liabilities have been forgiven by Allah jalla wa ala. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyil kareem wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajmain bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin.